Hello dear students and welcome to DAV Mobile Public School. Let's start our today's online session of Standard 9th Mathematics and today we will revise the unit probability. So let's see some questions based on the probability and what is the probability.
Now what is probability? Let's see some examples. Suppose a coin is tossed at random. The coin can land in one of two possible ways, either head up or tail up. You might have seen during matches also, coin is tossed and the either head or tail will come up. But we don't know, but definitely we know either head or tail. But certainly we can't tell whether head is come or tail is come. Now each outcome, head or tail, is as likely to occur as the other. Means chances of both head or tail is same. That is known as the outcomes head or tail are equally likely. So here total possible outcomes are two. When we toss a coin, total possible outcomes are two. But getting each outcome is one. Take another example. When we throw a die, the possible outcomes are, now you are aware about the die, six faces are there and on each face, the numbers are written as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So each number has the same possibility of showing up. Means either 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 comes. But definitely any one of these 6 numbers will come, not all 6 at a time. So the equally likely outcomes of throwing a die are either 1, 2, 3 or 5 or 5, 4 or 6. And therefore here the total possible outcomes are 6. But every time we throw a die, we will get only 1. It may be 1, it may be 2, it may be 3, maybe 4, maybe 5 or 6. So that is how throwing a die. Now what is probability actually in mathematical language? We define the probability of an event. Now in the previous two examples, we have seen the event as throwing a die and tossing a coin. So each process is known as an event and it is denoted by E. So probability of an event, whatever the event it is equal to number of the outcomes favorable to E divided by the total number of all possible outcomes for that particular experiment. So when a coin is tossed at random, total possible outcomes are two, means head or tail. But getting each outcome is one, means let E be the event. Here we are selecting getting a head, means our favorable outcome is getting a head, means if we want a head. So what is the probability of getting a head? The probability of getting a head is 1 and we will write it as probability of E. Here our event is getting a head is equal to number of outcomes favorable to E upon number of all possible outcomes of the experiment. Now here the number of getting head is 1 and the total possible outcomes are 2. So the probability of getting a head is equal to 1 by. Let's see the second example. Throw a die at random. Total possible outcomes are 6. Getting each outcome is 1. Means let E be the event, getting a number. Here I am taking out of 6, I am taking my favorable outcome as getting a number 5. The number of outcomes favorable to E that is getting pi is 1 because we are aware whenever we throw a die, any one number either of 1 to 6, any one is come up. So probability of E means probability of getting a number 5 equals to total number of outcomes favorable to E upon number of all possible outcomes of the experiment. So here getting 5 is 1, that is 1, and total possible outcome is 6. So probability of getting a number 5 is 1 by 6. Now here a bag contains a red ball, a blue ball and a yellow ball. Now Kriti takes out a ball from the bag without looking into it. What is the probability that she takes out the yellow ball, red ball, blue ball? Means here we have to find out the probability of getting yellow ball, red ball, blue ball. So for that first we will see the total possible outcomes are there. Now in the bag, how many balls are there? A red ball, a blue ball, a yellow ball, means total 3 balls are there. So our total possible outcomes are 3. Now yellow ball equals to 1. So we will write it as probability of getting yellow ball equals to, out of 3 we are getting only 1 time yellow ball. So probability of getting yellow ball equals to 1 by 3. Second question is of red ball. So probability of getting red ball equals to 1 by 3. And third is blue ball. Probability of getting blue ball equals to 1 by 3. So if you will see here, all ball having the probability 1 by 3 because out of 3 only 1 ball is of red, 1 ball is of blue and 1 ball is of yellow color. So both, all 3 have the same probability, that is 1 by 3. So from the above example, if we will see, we can conclude if we add all the events for the experiment of drawing a ball from a bag, that is probability of getting yellow ball plus probability of getting red ball plus probability of getting blue ball, we will get 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 means 3 by 3, that equals to 1. So the probability of the sure means possible event, you can see it a certain event also, is 1. But when the event is impossible, we can say the probability of an impossible event is 0. Now the probability of any event is lies between 0 and 1. Means either the probability is 0 or for the sure event it is 1, and in between that it lies. For any event E, P of E plus P of not E equals to 1. Means if you take the example of a coin, P of probability of getting head plus probability of getting not head. Not head is indirectly, we want to say it is a tail. No head means tail. So it is not E equals to 1. So these two numbers are also called the complementary numbers of each other. Complementary events. Now see one more example. Here a box contains 5 red marbles, 8 white marbles and 4 green marbles. One marble is taken out of the box. What is the probability that the marble taken out will be red, white, not green? My dear students, here not green means out of red, white and green, not green means it, for this question, for this not green word, it, we can say not green means the marble is either red or white. Understood? Now see the first, we have to calculate the probability of getting red. So here the total outcomes are not given, so we have to calculate it. In a bag, 5 plus 8 plus 4 means total 17 marbles are there. Our favorable outcomes for the first question is red, and red marbles equals to 5, and therefore probability of getting red marbles is equals to 5 upon 17. Second, our favorable outcome in the second question is white, and the second question white marbles are 8. and therefore probability of white marbles equals to 8/17. Third question, as we have discussed already, not green means it is either white or red. So for the favorable outcomes, we have to take both red and white, but we don't have to take it is green, because it is definitely given here no green, means we don't take the green. We take red and white, and that equals to 5 + 8 means 13. So probability of not green marble equals to 13/17. This is how to calculate the probability of the given favorable event. Now here is an assignment for you, short assignment. So dear students, today we have learnt about the probability, and I hope you might have clear ideas and better understanding. Here is an assignment for you that would help you to check your understanding, and I hope you will try honestly to solve the assignment. Thank you. Have a nice day.